cup beside is an old girl. I don't remember her name. I go out or I stay, I don't know. I lose my blue jeans. Fucking shit, was this time to hurt my back? If you think so, trust me, I'm not a bad guy.
Welcome to hell. Yeah, I know what you're thinking, but when I say hell, I mean hell. And look, I'm not a bad guy. One wrong turn, and I'm stuck down here with these dames, these fates, these three furies.
Poor thing. Someone should have told him bad luck comes in threes.
I'll be honest with you. I murdered my wife, shot her. I probably shouldn't have done that, but she's a broad that can really make a man crazy. And I almost got away with it.
Almost.
If it weren't for my shrink. This crazy dame threatened to blow the whistle on me, so I had to take her out too. Now, I didn't want to. I didn't even mean to.
Excuse me.
Okay, I meant to. But I regret it now. I wish my prints were on that gun. I wish I didn't have their blood on my hands. It's just, I get a little crazy if I don't take my pills. And you know the worst part of it is? When I was arrested, my girlfriend Heather
died of a broken heart?
Yes. But I wish you'd shut up and let me tell the story my way. I could really use a break here. A second chance. Now, if only I could...
What?
Go back in time.
Do things differently.
Follow another path.
Is that crazy?
Don't ask me, Mac. I'm not your shrink.
Sometimes, that's the only thing a guy like me wants. To turn back the clock. Right now, I've got three dead women on my tail. But if I could go back and put the gun someplace safe, call things off and straighten up. Nah. Who am I kidding? There's never any going back, is there?
Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe just this once.
Mac loves my brownies. He used to say that one of my brownies and three pills got him out of bed on the right side. We have a nice bedroom suite, and I sometimes joke with Mac that when your life is so pretty, there is no wrong side to get out of. We have a nice house. Mac has a nice face. There's rat poison in these. I've never tried making them like this before. Lately, I sometimes see Mac staring at me like he wishes I was someone else. The other day, he said, "Shove your goddamn carrot cake up your ass!" I think today, Mac and I will each have a brownie, and then things will be better.
One kind of hell. Brownies are a weapon.
Hi, honey, I'm home.
You're late!
I know. I'm sorry.
I forgive you. Brownie, dinner's burnt.
Oh, I said I'm sorry.
Charcoal casserole.
Oh, Beth, for God's sake.
Maybe I should just stick my head in the oven.
You see my problem here?
But we don't have gas.
Listen! If you weren't such a nagging crackpot, maybe I wouldn't be about to do this! Wait. I thought I was supposed to get rid of this thing. Avoid temptation. I'm gonna go see Julia before I do something stupid.
I became a
doctor because I wanted a big office with a smooth chrome desk and lots of pencils in a jar. Sharp pencils. And a view of the park with a lock on the door. I like to watch the trees change color, and I think that's very healthy. Don't you? I keep jelly beans and Valium in my drawer for special occasions, like when my patients are good. Though really, my favorite patients, they're bad. It's just the way I like them.
What happens on the love seat?
You're late.
I know, I'm sorry. I was walking, I was thinking.
Don't apologize, Mac, you're always late. I still bill by the hour.
It's not a very supportive thing for you to say, Doc.
Oh! Schmuckums, I told you. Call me Juliet.
As you point out, Juliet, I pay by the hour, so I like my money's worth, or rather, I like my wife's money's worth. I didn't want to come to you today, but I need your help.
Mac, sit. Let me take poor baby's worries away.
You run out of my pills and it's making me crazy.
Well, I just can't go handing out drugs, Mac. That would be responsible, wouldn't it? Besides, I like you a little crazy.
I've been thinking of killing my wife. Seen on my head, so real with all this blood, and I know I shouldn't do it, but you see my problem.
Fascinating. Let's talk about why you want your wife dead.
She's an ogre, but she's rich, and I want her off to Florida with someone else.
Three excellent motives. And this, someone else? Have anyone in mind?
Yes, Heather. She's a doll. She's doing anything for me.
Anything.
Sometimes when I ask her to do things. Never mind. About killing my wife. I can't do it. Can I? I mean, I know I shouldn't. One wrong turn in this town, it'll finish a man, but I want to. Such a dilemma. I feel like that famous Shakespeare character, you know?
Hamlet?
No, the other one. Listen, Doc. I have three requests.
Shoot.
Actually, that's what I like to avoid.
So what do you want from me?
Well, firstly, keep this meeting confidential. If anyone asks, I was never here. Second, I want you to look after this for me. And thirdly, can I have a jelly bean?
Anything you want, sweet pea.
I've never been to Florida. They say the moon there is made of gold and the stars are diamonds. I can't wait to see that. A girl has to choose her man carefully. It's a tough world, but some of us weren't built for tough, if you catch my drift. Mac better not let me down. I bought a new bikini. He can be a little soft sometimes, but I know how to harden him up. Hi, sweetie.
To flee or not to flee?
Heather!
All ready for the big trip?
Listen, about that. I think we need to talk.
We can talk all you like over pina coladas in Miami. Oh, Mac, do you suppose they have those there? I mean, they have coconuts, don't they? And what else are you supposed to do with a coconut?
Well, I don't know.
You're not going to disappoint me, are you?
Well.
Mac, sweetie, get it together. Kisses. By tomorrow, Mac and I will be on a plane to Florida. I might be trouble, but I'm worth it.
Single gun theory.
Or be careful what you wish for.
Oh, hello. Brownies?
What?
Fresh from the oven.
No, I don't want a brownie. Where's Mac?
Not here, but he'll be home soon. He's always...
Wait, yes, I know. He was supposed to meet me at the airport.
changing his mind like that. I mean, I've packed already.
I'm his wife, Beth. So who are you, dear?
Your worst nightmare?
Really? Well, that's odd.
My worst nightmare involves this guy in a big cape with sunglasses and blonde hair and thigh-high boots and a whip. And
oh, no, that's not the nightmare. No, wait!
You look like?
I'm sorry?
Mac never said. Is he here? I came as soon as I could.
Mac, no. He's not here. Not yet.
Oh, good! Thank God we can rely on Mac to wander around for half an hour before keeping appointments.
Who are you?
Your worst nightmare.
This sounds kind of familiar, so it's about now that I'm tipped off that this isn't going to go so well for me.
You bitch!
Well, don't look so surprised. You know what they say about the theater. You can't have a gun without a body.
Hi, honey. I'm home. Doc, what are you doing here?
You said she would do anything for you, but you were wrong.
What?
I, on the other hand, really would do anything. Anything. I know what you want, what you need, and I'm just mad enough to make the necessary actions. It's your lucky day, Mac. I love you!
Oh my God, is that a...
What? Isn't Schmookums glad I killed his nasty old wife for him?
This isn't my wife, this is my girlfriend, Heather.
That's Heather? This is her house. What the hell is she doing here?
Where the hell is my wife?
Don't worry about that now. It's just you and me.
Oh, forget it, Juliet. I can never love a twisted broad like you.
Oh, shit. Really?
Get off.
Damn! That was a waste of effort. And my prints are all over that thing. Oh well.
Guess there's only one way out now.
Oh, happy dagger. Let me die.
Someone down here must be wearing a toga. Regret the sharp-toothed dog, and make no mistake, I got bit 3 times.
Poor thing. Someone should have told him. You cannot run face.
And you don't have to pull the trigger to be guilty.
Welcome to hell, Mac.
Brownie?